Myself Naveen, and I am associated with Testprepkart. In this session, we are going to talk about JEE Physics. So, as you know that JEE is one of the most reputed examination in India, and when we prepare for JEE Physics, we must keep in mind one thing, that in JEE, question never repeats, okay, but concept repeats always, okay. So we must have very much clarity about the concept, and during the preparation process, we must develop an approach that how we can Yeah, so we need to develop an approach that how we can proceed for any problem. So to just give you a better idea, here we are going to discuss a very fundamental topic of JEE Physics, okay, which is at grade 11th level, that is laws of motion. Okay, so I hope you already completed this chapter in your school.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then it will be more interesting to discuss this topic because you are already aware about some of the part. So let's start from some fundamentals, that when we talk about laws of motion, so it's all about force. What do you know about force?
Force is a push or pull applied on an object.
Okay. Force is a push or pull applied on an object that having capacity to break inertia of the object. Okay. So, force can be classified in two categories. One is field force. Another is contact force. Okay. So, do you have any idea what is field force? Yeah. What is field force? Okay, no problem. Look, have you ever seen that when we bring a magnet near to any iron piece, then that iron piece will get attracted towards the magnet? Agree or not?
Yes.
Yeah. Or if you drop something from certain height, so it will automatically fall towards earth. Okay. It means there is some force which does not require physical contact. Okay. So whenever for the application of force, no physical contact is needed. Then we call it field force. Okay. Like magnetic force or gravity. On the other hand, if physical contact is necessary for applying the force, then we call it contact force, like tension or friction. Okay, etc. These are contact force. Okay. So, in this session, we are just going to focus on contact forces only. We will not talk about field force. So, are you aware about Newton's first, second and third law?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, great. So, you can just understand all these things. So, I'm not going into that. Okay. Let's talk about some other thing. That suppose we have an object and we are applying two force on this object. One is F1, another is F2. So, can you please tell me what will be the net force on this body?
Net force, right?
Yeah.
Net force is zero, sir.
Yes?
Zero, right?
Is it F1 minus F2 or F1 plus F2? It is F1 minus F2. Because force is a vector quantity, so in this case, direction is also important. Okay? Now see, if we assume that total force on this body is equals to zero, will there be any change in balance condition of this body?
No.
No. It means due to these two forces, there is no disturbance in balance of the body, so we can call them balanced force. On the other hand, if this total force is not equals to zero, then what will happen?
There is no balance.
Yeah, then body will start moving in direction of greater force. Then we call them unbalanced force. Okay. Now see, from here we can just frame laws of motion problems in three categories. Okay, so here I am just going to discuss the methods of problem solving. Okay, I am not getting into the concept because you are already aware about this. Okay, so let's try to understand that how to approach the problems. So, entire Newton's law of motion problem can be classified in three categories. Okay. First category is static. Static condition. Okay. Static condition means whenever there is no motion in the system. Okay? There is no motion in the system. Then we call it static condition. In case of a static condition, we apply concept of equilibrium. Are you aware about this concept? What is equilibrium? Equilibrium means when total force working on body is equals to zero. Okay, so whenever you get any problem on static condition, you have to do only one thing. just resolve all forces in X direction and in Y direction. Okay? And separately put total force in X direction equals to 0 and total force in Y direction is equals to 0. Okay? Then you will able to solve any problem of static condition. Okay. So, before getting into this, you need to draw free body diagram. Okay. Are you aware about this free body diagram? Okay, look, free body diagram is when you show all visible and hidden forces working on a body in a single diagram, we call it free body diagram. Okay? Now let's see how to utilize this concept. Suppose there is a ceiling and there is one object of mass 10 kg. Okay? And this object is connected with two strings. Both are making 30 degree angle. Okay? Now the question is, if gravitational acceleration is 10 meter per second square, then find T, find tension in string. Okay? Now see, first you have to decide whether it is a static condition or condition of motion. Is there any motion in this system?
No, sir.
No. So we can clearly say that it is a static problem. Okay. So first step is to draw free body diagram. So we'll just cut this string from here, and whenever you deal with the string, please remember that tension always act away from the body. Okay. So I have taken this body of 10 kg. There are two tension of same amount working at angle 30 degree. Okay? And due to gravity, there will be a force which is M into G. Okay? And this M into G is equals to 100 newtons. Okay? So what I just told you, that you have to find all forces in X direction and in Y direction. So first of all, we need to resolve these forces in X direction and in Y direction. So can you please help me in finding its component in X direction? Okay, I think you are not aware about this concept. So let me tell you that if there is any vector, it can be force or something else, it is making an angle theta. Okay, so you can break this vector in two components. One component is F cos theta and another component will be F sin theta. Okay, this concept is called resolution of vectors. Okay, so you need to keep in mind this concept because it is very useful. Okay. So now can you now find out this component of this T? Yes, look. T is making. Yes, T cos. T cos. T sin theta. Okay?
It should be 90, right?
Yes?
T sin 90. It should be T sin 90, right?
I'm not getting you. What are you saying?
The y-axis, the angle should be 90 degree, right?
Yeah, yeah. This angle, y-angle should be 90 degree. This one. Both lines should be perpendicular to each other.
Yeah.
Okay. Similarly, we can find out component of this tension. This is also T cos 30, and in upward direction it is T sin 30. Okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we can write equations in x direction and in y direction. So can you help me in writing equation in x direction? Force in x direction.
X direction is cos 30.
Very good. T cos 30. And?
Y direction is...
Wait. In x direction, there are two forces. This one and this one. So we must write T cos 30 minus T cos 30 is equals to 0. Okay?
It's balanced.
Yeah, balanced. Now similarly, tell me equation in y direction.
T sin 30.
And?
Downward also.
Look, in upward there are two forces. T sin 30 and T sin 30. One for this, another for this. So we have to take T sin 30 plus sin 30 minus 100 equals to 0. Because this force is in opposite direction. So you have to take negative sign. So what we'll get? 2T is equals to 100. Now what is sin 30?
Sin 30, 1 by 2.
1 by 2, very good. So from here we'll get T equals to 100 Newton. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So just be very clear in your mind that first of all, you have to identify the situation, whether it is stationary or moving. If it is stationary, then just draw all forces, resolve them in x direction and in y direction, and apply this condition that total force in x equals to 0 and total force in y equals to 0. You will directly get the answer. Okay. So, let me give you another problem and you try to solve this. Then we'll discuss another concept. So, again, I am just taking similar problem that there is a ceiling. And we have taken one object of mass 10 kg. And connected with the help of two strings. One is making angle 60 degree with this line. Another is making angle 30 degree. In this string, there is tension T1. And in this string, there is tension T2. Okay? Again, if G is equals to 10 meter per second square, then find T1 and T2. Okay, please try to solve this problem.
So first of all we have to get into free body diagram.
Yes, first draw free body diagram. Do you have pen and paper?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so please try to solve this. Okay. Yeah, have you got the same free body diagram?
Yes, sir. I got the same, but when I am taking FX and FY, I am getting really confused.
Look. Whenever you get confused, just draw two lines with the help of pencil or anything. Just draw one horizontal line, okay, and one vertical line. All forces falling in this line will be the forces in x direction, and forces falling in this line will be the forces in y direction. Now you can easily see. There are two forces along this line. One is this T1 cos 30, another is T2 cos 30. So you can easily write total force in x direction is equals to T1 cos 60 minus T2 cos 30. It is equals to 0. Okay. Similarly, you can see there are two forces, this one, and third one is this. All three are along this line, along y-axis. So you can take them in y-direction. So what will be the equation?
T1 sin 60.
Very good.
Plus cos 30.
No, T2 sin 30. Yes. And?
Minus 100.
Very good. Is equals to 0. Now please solve this. You will get the answer. Yes.
Right?
Yes.
T1 is equal to U3 T2 minus 1.
Yes, good, it is right. And second?
T2 is equal to
Are you getting similar equation? Here you can check in the board. This is first equation and this is second equation. Okay?
First equation.
Yeah. So you can put value of T1 in equation number 2. Okay? So what you will get? Root 3T2 into root 3 by 2 plus T2 by 2. So if you solve this, I think you will easily get value of T2. Yeah, it is 3 by 2 T2 plus T2 by 2 is equals to 100. So from here you will get 4 T2 is equals to 100. So T2 equals to, oh, one second. T2 equals to 50 Newton. Oh God. 50 Newton. Is it right?
Yes, yeah, it should be right.
Yeah. So now once you got value of T2, 50, then using this
Yes,
just substitute in this, you will get T1 equals to 50 root
3.
Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So now see, the first category of problem in laws of motion is static problem. What is important? You just need to identify that problem and draw free body diagram and you will get the answer. Okay. Like, please see question number 5. Yeah, this one. Question number 5. Okay, which of the following statement are correct? So let me write the statement. Option A is, these are 4 options and you have to choose which one is right. Just see, just look at this problem and first get a conclusion that whether it is static or it is moving.
It's a sphere, so it's not static.
It is static. Okay. So one thing is very clear that we have to draw a free body diagram and write total force in x direction is equals to 0 and total force in y direction is equals to 0.
Y direction.
Okay. So just do that basic thing, that there are three forces. So just resolve them and write the equation and you will get the answer.
What is the Newton here?
Okay, look. In this case, two forces are given. One is W, another is R. Okay, in this case, amount is not given. So you just need to find answer in terms of R and W. Are you getting same free body diagram? Like this?
Yes, sir, I got it.
Okay, so you just need to write the equations then. In this direction and this direction. So what are the equations?
Theta 1 plus theta 2 minus r I know, that is f of y
Wait, wait. From where you are getting theta 1 and theta 2?
The angles is given there.
Look dear. I think here you are getting a bit confused. Let's see. If this string is connected like this, and one angle is theta, so along y direction, its alternate angle will be also equals to theta. Okay? Agree or not? So you can just resolve along this line that first component will become t cos theta and the perpendicular component will become t sin theta. Okay? Or let me draw it here if you are doing in another way. Like we have got tension like this, t here. And suppose if this angle is theta, then definitely this angle will be 90 minus theta. Okay? So if you take this component as t cos theta, so t cos 90 minus theta, which is just equivalent to t sin theta. Okay? Is it clear or not? No, otherwise, let me, I can explain it again from the very beginning. Okay. Look, let me explain it in detail. Just remember one thing. That if any... Yeah, please.
I'm confused for taking the course that R and W was proper.
Look dear. R and W are already in X direction and in Y direction. So we don't need to disturb them. Okay? You just need to find out component of T. Because T is not in X or Y direction. Okay? Look. One second. See. If this ball is connected like this with the help of a string, there is one force R and one force W. This is tension T and this angle is theta. Okay? So first we identified that this is a static condition. So we have to find out total force in F, X direction is equals to 0 and total force in Y direction is equals to 0. It means I have to find out force along this line and force along this line. Okay? So R is already in same direction along X direction. Okay? And W is already along Y direction. So I have to break this force T in X direction and in Y direction. Okay, so this angle, if this angle is theta, then this angle will be alternate. It is also equals to theta. So I can break this component as T cos theta and T sin theta. Okay, now we have completed our first task. Now we can write the equations. So, if you write equation along x-axis, so you can see there are two forces. Okay? So, it is R minus T sin theta, which is equals to 0. Okay? So, we can write R equals to T sin theta. Similarly, if you look in vertical direction along this line, so you will get total force along y direction is equals to T cos theta minus W is equals to 0. Okay, it means P cos theta is equals to W. Up to this point, is it clear or not? Okay, so once you got two equations, you can just square and add these two equations. So if you square, you will get T square sine square theta is equals to R square, and T square cos square theta is equals to W square. Now if we'll add these two equations, then what we'll get? T square into cos square theta plus sine square theta is equals to R square. Now what is this?
1.
1. So you have got T square equals to R square plus W square. So what is T? Under root R square plus. So this is correct answer.
So, when I went wrong, my assumption was wrong.
Yeah, your starting point was wrong, that you just started in wrong direction. So, that's why I am suggesting that whenever you get any problem, just with the help of pencil or any other color pen, draw X line and Y line. Okay? And after that, start resolving all forces along these lines. Then it would be very easy for you. Okay. Okay, let's see another problem, just similar type of problem. Once you will get into the practice, then you will find all these questions are very simple. Okay, just look at question number 7. Yes. Are you doing or should I explain this?
Doing, sir, but I'm stuck in halfway.
Okay. So, up to which point you have done? Can you tell me?
I got the angles and the diagram is perfect.
Okay. So, let me draw the free body diagram. And please check whether you got the similar diagram or not. Okay. I am getting one force in this direction, 30 Newton. One force in this direction. I am just taking this as weight because I have to calculate the weight of the body. And this, let's take tension in this string. That is T. And it is making angle 45 degrees. So, I will break two components. One is T cos 45, another is T sin 45. You got similar diagram or is there any difference?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is the difference?
Oh, I got similar.
Okay, then once you got the similar diagram, then you can, I think, now easily approach. Now see, you just draw two lines as I told you. One is X
and Y.
Another is Y. Okay? And now just write equations. What is equation in X direction?
Cos.
Yes.
Sine 45. It is sine 45.
Yes.
Minus sine
45. Minus 30 equals to
13 equals 0.
Okay. And what equation in y direction?
Cos 45.
T cos 45. Yes.
Plus.
There is nothing else in this area.
So it's minus W.
Minus W equals to 0. Okay. Now just look at the equation number 1. You almost done this question. What is sine 45?
And 1/√2.
1/√2. That is equals to 30. So what is T?
30√2.
Just substitute this value in this equation. It is into cos 45. Cos 45 is again 1/√2. Okay. So W is equals to 30. So you are just near to the solution. So you just need to build up some confidence. Okay. Then at least you can solve all static problems. There is nothing else apart from this concept. Okay. Like you can see this question. Question number 9. It is looking a bit difficult, but it is very easy problem.
Which question, sir? 9?
One second, let me read this. For the service only because the pulleys are light and fixing this, the tension in the string will be. Okay, let's leave this problem because it is based on motion. Okay, so you will face and it will take a lot of time. Okay, so for today's session, we are just limiting up to this point. Okay, after the class, you can try to practice all those static problem in your book, okay, then you will get a lot of confidence in that. Okay, so I think it is sufficient for today. Now you can log out.